guys, good afternoon. Okay, so welcome back again to my channel. Welcome back to Vanessa's Televlog. So since wala na akong vlog this past few days, nag-decide ako na gawin na yung second video pertaining or regarding about the disadvantage or struggle of being an online teacher. So ngayon naman is ang aking topic is all about the advantages. Okay, I think mas maraming advantages kesa disadvantages or struggle. Kasi yung struggle naman is yun lang yung mga mararanasan mo all throughout your teaching career. Okay, so nowadays, marami naman akong advantages na sobrang na-appreciate ko very much na pangyayari. Since etong ang pandemic na ito is really storming us. So, very much thankful for this job. Kasi, nasa bahay lang ako and I'm earning, okay? I'm even earning as much as those who are working outside or those who are working office space. So yun. So first, okay, so without so much further ado, okay, so number one is, as you can see, di ba, I'm wearing just a shirt, pero hindi naman siya revealing. Hindi siya plunging neckline, so you can wear casual, okay, but not too casual that you have to wear some sandals, spaghettis, and everything, okay, that is not allowed, okay. And then, yun nga, comfy, comfortable, okay. And then, second is, lalayo pa ba tayo? Lalayo pa ba? Ano ba yun? I mean, hindi ko na, sasabihin ko siya, hindi siya enumerate. Ano ba yun? Yung parang sunod-sunod dapat. Hindi, kung ano lang yung una kong maisip, yun. Pero, pinaka talaga dyan, I think, is, hindi ka na magta-transportation. You don't have to go out and then travel for at least an hour or less going to your office. So, yun ang wala sa amin. And I'm thankful for that kasi I don't like naman to go on office space. Kasi there were lots of opportunities na nag-cross naman ang path ko before. But I chose not to grab that opportunity kasi dito pala talaga ako sa aking kwarto mag-work. Okay, and then hassle-free kasi you can wake up even 25 minutes before your duty kung ayaw mong maligo muna kasi hindi ka naman nila maamoy. So yun, so right after your bed is your office work, oo tama, working stations like that. And then, hindi ka nagagastos ng pamasahe mo pag magbibiyahe ka papuntang office. Hindi na mababawasan yung minimum mo if ever na you're earning a minimum wage of 500 something. Hindi mo na yun mababawasan kasi hindi ka naman magbibiyahe. And then, you're not gonna eat outside because nandito ka nga lang din naman sa house nyo. Then, kung ano yung kinakain mo usually, yun na lang din yung kakainin mo. Hindi ka na mararattle na, mabili ako, kain ako sa masarap na ganito kasi mostly of my office mates were eating outside. Like, actually, pinaka-basic na nga yung McDo, Jollibee, di ba? Pero mahal pa rin para sa atin yon. Pero basic na yon, ha? Pero, ganun lang. And then, so, 500, halimbawa, your minimum is 500, hindi mo na yun mababawasan. Solong-solo mo na yung 500, ang pro-problemahin mo na lang is yung kung gusto mong kumain ng kung anik-anik na gusto mo, hindi mo mabili kasi nasa loob ka lang ng bahay. Pero you can go outside, right? Bakit ang McDo ba nasa loob ng opisina? Hindi, di ba? And then, ayun. So, hindi ko na alam, nakailan na ba ako? Wala kang bossing na kasama na mag-i-stress sa'yo. Stress. I'm not saying na ang mga boss is stress. Meron namang mga mababait. Pero mostly, di ba, sa ating mga superiors is minsan nakaka-stress sila pag nakikita natin sila dyan na walking around us, like as if investigating. And then, yun, we don't have that kind of supervisors. Although, our lessons were being evaluated, pero ano, you will not know. Kayon, pero ano, it's up to you na lang on how to perform your professionalisms during your class. And then what else? Advantages is that, yun nga, about sa salary is mas malaki pa yung sahod mo as an online English teacher na home-based rather than those who are working in a private company or even in a public company na naka-office base. Because in here, in 5-1 Talk, since this is my first job na sa ESL, is I am earning a minimum of 1,000 and a maximum of 1,500 a day. So, yon. Aside from, you are having those kind of perks, which are bonuses, incentives. Okay, so yon. I am not bragging or saying anything na ang laki ng sahod namin, no, it's not. Ano lang, compared to others, okay, but not all, kasi I know naman na there's a lot of company who are offering those very big company na they offered a lot and much money for their employee. And that's okay for me since I am working here naman, and then low pressure kasi low pressure or no pressure. No, hindi ko pa naranasan ang no pressure. Of course, I am pressured kasi I am teaching a student whom I meet for the first time every day. And then, what else? I am looking at my watch because may klase ako after this. So, as of today, 2:30 p.m., may klase ako ng alas 3. And then, what else? The advantages. Yon, if I got tired from work, nagko-close ako ng aking schedule for 4 hours. Maximum of 4 hours. And minimum of 2 hours. Ang aking binivacant. And natutulog ako noon. Can you sleep on your work when you are on office base? Like you have to work for 8 hours, you're not allowed, right? You are only allowed to take your lunch, to have your tea time, but you're not allowed to sleep for that long. Okay, so it's despite the fact that I am sleeping for 4 hours, I'm still earning that 1,000 to 1,500 a day. Okay, what else? And then, advantages, ano pa ba? Of course, I can pay a lot of things. I can pay my bills. I can buy clothes. I can buy shoes. I can buy bags and everything. And I can sustain my needs, okay, because of this job. And then what else? Ayun, and then pinaka na-enhance talaga sa akin is since I love English even before, ano, mas na ano siya na enhance or mas na priority ko yung pag-i-English. Kasi before, sa mga previous job ko, although I work abroad, they don't require us to, or that job doesn't require me to just to be fluent in English or dire-diretsong pag-i-English siya. Although English talaga kasi you will not understand each other kung hindi kayo mag-i-English na dalawa. Since abroad yon, magkaibang lahi kayo. Pero it doesn't mean na kapag nag-i-English kayo, dapat correct grammar before. So as long as nagkakaintindihan kayo, it's okay. But this time, you have to be fluent? Sige. You have to be correct grammar if ever yan maging fluent talaga. And then I practiced this talking in English completely, okay, and yon nadadala ko siya after my job. So maganda naman kasi hindi ko naman sinabing napaka-importante ang pag-i-English, pero favorite ko kasi siya even before, so na-enhance siya and nagustuhan ko siya. Diba, magsisimula na ako magpaganda kasi magkaklase na ako. And then what else? Ayun, I have a lot of time spending with my family, with my husband kapag nandito siya during his day off. Nagko-close ako ng maraming oras. Tapos nagbabanding kami, o, diba? Maraming bagay na mas maganda talaga ang home base kesa sa office base. So, yun. But before, I wanted to work in a company as a secretary, as a normal employee. Yung wearing your IDs, wearing your something, and wearing lipstick and kind of everything. Pero dito naman sa akin kasi, I'm always wearing lipstick. I wanted to be presentable for the student. And then, we have this, okay? We have this to be more formal, okay? And for the student to easily recognize us that we are from 5-1 Talk. And then we have that shirt, okay? But we are not that required to wear that shirt every day, the 5-1 Talk shirt na may logo dito. You have to wear at least once a day, at least once a week, twice a week, but not every day. It's okay as long as you are wearing this. I forgot ano nga tawag dito, lanyard. Okay, yun, I remember na lanyard ang tawag nila dito. So yun, actually I don't wear t-shirts like this usually. Medyo mga one time every two weeks yun, kasi mas prefer ko yung may kwelyo. But since I have this lanyard na, nagiging formal na rin siya, diba? And then, ano pa ba? Yun, aside from I can buy a lot of things because of my salary in here, pwede na rin akong sumuport sa aking parents sa province namin. Ayan. Yun lang, maganda doon. Tapos, ang pinakamaganda talaga is yung hindi ka nalalabas. Diyan ka lang sa bahay nyo. Maghilamos ka man o hindi, hindi na yun mapapansin na mga estudyante mo. And then, oops, working area ka na. So yun lang. Ano pa ba? Sa mga teacher dyan ng ESL, kung marami pa kayong masasabi, it's okay. The comment section is openly and widely open for you. Openly and wide. Yun, widely open for you to just type in there. Okay? Yung mga gusto nyo pang idagdag sa mga advantages. Since, siguro marami pa akong hindi nasasabi, pero yun. And, sa disadvantages pala, next video ko ulit. Marami pa pala akong naisip na wala naman sa ESL na meron sa ibang company. So, yun. Yun lang muna, guys, ang aking video for today. So, that's it for my video for today. Thank you for watching my vlog and my video for today. And, I am asking for a permission na din to use this while having that vlog and using my tarpaulin while having my vlog. So, for those who are working in a company of 5-1 Talk, yung mga admin, if ever na ma-watch nyo to, I'm sorry if I don't have the chance or I did not get any permission to pause a video wearing this lanyard and my background. It was then that I am so happy to be part of your company, and it was then that I'm so overwhelmed of being an online English teacher. So yun lang, guys. Thank you again. Bye bye.